we can look up in the sky. The tears we cry, let us know that we alive. Yeah, yeah. It give me goosebumps every time I throw up my diamond. Together we big time.
And I put in work with all my might. I know that he got me now by sight. Yeah.
And welcome to my channel. I'm Tasha, or you can refer to me as Precious Gem. Either way, I will respond to Bo. And just to let you know, I call you friend because I call everybody that I'm cool with friend. But if you not new to my channel and you already a subscriber, then you already know everything that I just said. And yeah, we're just gonna hop right into this video. So when it comes to achieving self-skin in one day, it all starts with your bath or your shower. I'm going to demonstrate how to achieve self-skin taking a bath. So basically, once you run your bath water, you will want to add 1 to 2 cups of baking soda into your bathtub. That's the first way to achieve soft skin. You don't have to add nothing else to your tub. There's been plenty of days where I have only used baking soda and nothing else in my bathtub, and my skin is baby soft. But I also have another product that I use to achieve baby soft skin, and I kind of switch up between the two. And what this is the Calgon. You can find this at Walmart, but I basically just pour however much that I think is enough. But of course, direction come on the back of the box, but who read directions? Here are the 2 things that I will add to my bathtub. You do not have to use both. As a matter of fact, I would suggest that you only use one or the other. I would suggest that you start off with the baking soda and use it by itself. And trust me, you're gonna be amazed. Switch backwards and forth between the two. And like I said, you do not have to add no extra to your bathtub. But of course, because I'm extra, I'm in the mood for my bath to be extra. So I'm gonna just add a little bit more.
Just relax
and take ourselves a nice hot bubble bath. And I only take bubble baths. If you need me, I'll be in the bubble bath. Bubble baths.
So I'm done with my bath. We're gonna move right into the moisturizer. And the moisturizer that I use for my skin is baby oil. This is the most important step. Like, regardless to if you put the baking soda into your tub, if you put the Calgon into your tub, or if you decide to just take the shower, if you only use this baby oil gel, it's going to give you the results. Let me show you guys up close. I use the Equate brand. You can also use the brand version, which is Johnson Johnson. I also have that. It's like a $3 difference in price, but how you apply this is very important. What you want to do when you get out the shower or the bathtub, the first thing that you absolutely never want to do is dry off with a dry off towel. Of course, I'm using this for the purpose of the video because I don't think y'all want to see me nude. I don't think y'all do. When you get out the shower or the tub, your skin is still wet. And so the way that you want to dry off is with the towel that you used already to wash up with. Or if you didn't use a towel, you use a loofah, or you want to take a face towel at this point and you want to wet it, you want to stick it up in the water. You never want to use a dry towel. Not a dry towel, not a dry face towel. And what you do is just wring the water out, and you will take the towel and you will rub your skin. And it's basically how you dry off. And the purpose of this is it's going to take the excess water off your skin. But at the same time, it's going to leave your skin damp. And that's what is needed in order for you to get the max results with the baby oil moisturizer. Water is what hydrates your skin. Water is what hydrates your hair. The key to keeping that hydration is to be able to lock it in. And basically, that's what the baby oil gel is going to do. And by my skin still being damp and me applying the baby oil gel, it's gonna make it work. It's even more effective. The end result is going to be deep, moisturized, hydrated skin that you're gonna love. I basically apply a very small amount. You probably need maybe a pea size, or I say a dime size amount. And you can use it. The amount that I got, I say this is probably about a quarter size amount. Take it and rub it into my hands. And then I'm going to apply it to my skin. So it's in both hands now. And when you initially apply it to your skin, you just want to glide it across your skin as of now. Like, you're not trying to rub it in, not just yet. You're just trying to get the moisturizer off your hand onto your skin. So just gliding. And you will continue to do the same with this side also. You just want to glide, glide. Okay, I think y'all get the point. I know y'all get the point. And so once you have applied the moisturizer to your skin, now you want to go back and you want to massage it in. And you guys, how I do this, like, some days I jump in the shower and I'm rushing and I just, you know, quickly rub it in and I continue on my way and my skin is baby soft. And then other times I have more time on my hand, and so I really take the time to massage it in. Like, either or, your skin gonna be soft. But if you have the extra time, then go ahead and cater to your skin and just massage it in.
Okay, so moving right on into how I achieve soft feet in one day. Now, I do have a foot regimen that I will use, but for whatever reason, if I don't have the time to be consistent with it, I will use this foot warming mask, and it delivers exactly what it says, deeply hydrated feet. The instructions are on the back of the foot mask, so I'm not going to go into details about how to apply it and how to use it for the sake of this video, but do know that I prefer this method over going to get a pedicure any day. Okay, so I'm going to open up the package and show you guys what the booties look like that are inside.
It's like a little 4-pack. And they in the shape of little booties or whatever. You get two of them in a package. Like so. Just rip them apart. And you want to make sure that your feet are clean before you apply this mask. But of course, you would just take scissors, open the booty. You would take your feet and put it over inside the booty. And you would leave it for 20 minutes. If I have extra time, I'll leave it on for longer than 20 minutes. And I would take my heating pad and I also apply that to my feet, and I just chill and relax, and it works every time. In order for me to maintain the results that I do get from this foot mask, I do have a foot regimen that I use to take care of my feet, because you know the area does need special care. Besides that, this is what I would initially use. I would use a foot peeling mask, and it's by Oxy.
Okay guys, so I'm going to show you guys what this mask looks like and how I apply it. But do know that if you only use the 4 booty that I initially showed you, you will get results. And so this is the booty out of the package, and you just take it and apply it to your feet. You want to size it and make sure that it fit. It comes with this tape for further reinforcement. So if you are someone who goes to the nail salon and get pedicures, and you know the nail tech will scrub the bottom of your feet, she'll take the razor and rid it of the rough dry skin, just know that this method that I'm used, like, it can't even be compared. It's just that good. You're gonna just want to do it at home, because they can't even touch on these results. They cannot even dare achieve these results. Will leave this booty on for 30 minutes. Preferably try to sit still when you're wearing it. Try not to walk around. I mean, of course, directions are going to come on the back of the package once again, so do make sure you read that. I'm not going to go into detail for the sake of not making this video that long. And so your results are going to start to happen over the course of 5 to 7 days. During that process, your feet will begin to peel. And not only just the bottom of your feet will begin to peel, but anywhere on your feet that you have dead skin. For example, my toes begin to peel, under my toes begin to peel, the side of my feet begin to peel. So yeah, just know this foot peel is most definitely gonna get your feet together. During this time when your feet begin to peel, you don't have to do anything special. You still can wash your feet, you still can lotion and grease your feet, take baths, whatever you choose. But do know that your feet will begin to peel, so you might not want to wear open toe shoes during that time. And I just must warn y'all, when y'all feeling this soft, like your man ain't gonna be able to stop rubbing on you, that could be a plus if you don't mind. Of course I don't mind. Like, I love for my man to rub on me, I love for him to compliment me, so I love everything about feeling self.
Moving right on to my next hack, and that is how to make your perfume slash body spray have more projection. And this is just pretty simple. So what you're gonna do is take your body spray of your preference, or you're gonna take your perfume of preference. The only way that this works is that you have the lotion to go with it. Oh no, I take that back. You don't have to have a lotion to go with it. If you know how to mix and match different scents, then you can apply any lotion to any spray and achieve these results. But so what you basically want to do is take your body spray. I'm using the Almond Blossom. I purchased this from Bath & Body. So you just want to take it, spray yourself. Y'all, I always tend to go overboard. I really don't be knowing my limit. And you want to take the lotion to go with it. I'm going to use the matching lotion. You can match and match. Like, if I want to use a different lotion to go with this, I could. But unfortunately, when it comes to matching and matching scents, I'm not that great at it. So I just leave it alone, because I wind up smelling like something that I shouldn't. And so you just rub the lotion into your hands, and then you just want to put it on your clothes. Apply it to your clothes. And you can apply it however much you want to, however little that you want to. And this is going to give your body spray the projection that you're looking for. Also, you can do it with your perfume. Like I say, I do have a rose scent to match this perfume. And so you just spray your perfume on. Oh, that smells so good. Oh my god, I think I'm gonna wear that today. I'm gonna wear rose today. And you want to take the lotion, rub it into your hand, and you just apply it to your clothes. Keep in mind, you don't want to apply this to your skin. I do not apply this to my skin. And there you go, you'll be smelling like a snack all day. And basically, that's it. Also, guys, let me put y'all on to this last little trick. I know I didn't tell y'all I was gonna do this, but this trick is if you want your significant other to remember you, you could take your scent. And I do this, y'all. Take your scent and you spray his covers. You can spray his pillow, and you don't want to use that much. Now, I don't overdo it when it comes to doing that. And y'all, he gone think about you all day and all night. Trust me, I used to do this to my friend, because I'm extra like that. Like, before I leave, I would spray his cover or his pillow or both. And y'all, he used to be calling me, texting me, telling me like, I'm not there, but my smell's still there. So I'm there, but I'm not there. Like, telling me my smell is driving him insane. Like, just wildly in love. And you know, a smell, a person like your smell, it can go such a long ways with them. So I say only do that to somebody if you're really feeling them. Just don't be randomly walking around spraying people covers and pillows that you're not really messing with on that level. But of course, since you've grown, so of course, friend, you grown, so you're gonna do what you want to do. And then my last hack that I want to show you guys, this right here, this hack is gonna keep your wop smelling good 7 days a week. It's gonna keep you feeling confident. It's gonna keep you ready for whatever. It's gonna make you not have no second thoughts. Like, we can have a tendency to just naturally sweat down there, some worse than other. And if you don't get waxed and you have hairs down there, then them hairs can have a tendency to hold on to that scent, even from you going to the bathroom. And even if you wipe with tissue, like, them, your hairs can still hold on to that scent. But y'all, I got the perfect remedy for that cootie gap. And basically, it's the summer eve wipes. Y'all, I got the wipes that's on it to go. I'm gonna show y'all what it look like. And I wish I had my purse down here, but I don't. Say if this was my purse, these are like to go wipes. So I just throw them in my purse. And I, even with a real small purse, I'm gonna show y'all. Like, if I compare that to my palm, you see that it's not that big. And so every time I go to the bathroom, I just wipe myself with this to-go wipe. And so all my ladies who have sensitive skin, I also have sensitive skin. And this was specifically made in mind for women with sensitive skin. My sensitive skin is very bad. I don't use no Bath and Body shower gels. I have to be very careful what shower gels that I use. If I use the wrong shower gel, then I'll be very irritated. However, these wipes, I can use them and I have no issue with them whatsoever. But we all know everybody is different. So I would say try using it, take your chance. If it worked for you, then you in there. And if it don't, then I'm so, so sorry. But I take this wipe and, of course, wipe myself from front to back. And then I also take, I wipe the crevice. Let me show y'all. I will also wipe the crevice with this wipe because we do sweat in our bikini area. And it's going to keep you, like, it's going to keep you fresh, like I said. And it's going to keep you very confident. Very confident. Like, you're not going to have no second thought about it. I do know women who carry around towels with them, trying to keep themselves fresh, carry around soap, or wash up throughout the day several times, and that can be a hassle. So this right here is just an easy remedy. And then I also use the wipes, you guys. And these, like, your at-home wipes or whatever, I keep them on the back of the toilet. And they the same thing. And you just keep them in a little pouch. They package in a pouch like this. And you take them all in. Of course, what I just showed you, you do that all over again. Front to back. I wipe the inside of my bikini area. And that's what I do to stay fresh. Okay, guys, so this is the end of this video. I thank you guys for staying tuned and watching it to the end. And I will see y'all in my next vlog.
I put in work with all my might. I know that he got me, got me, got me, now by sight.